studio now by Giulio Cerroni from IXICO. Giulio, afternoon to you. Good to see you.
Afternoon.
Your half-yearly report out today. Of course, we'll get to that in a moment. First off, our first chance to actually meet you in your new role at IXICO. Remind us what IXICO's focus is.
Yeah, thank you, Andrew. So, yeah, IXICO is very focused on supporting our pharmaceutical customers in their drug development programs. We've built a unique digital platform, and that platform allows us to collect, extract, and analyze data from medical images, for example, from MRIs. Mm-hmm. And we provide very clever analytics to support those pharmaceutical companies in their drug development programs so that they can make decisions around whether to take a drug into the next phase of that program. And you'll know that those programs are very costly, multi-year programs where companies are spending hundreds of millions of dollars on. So this is a mission-critical service for them. So our being a partner to them is very important to their success. So that's what we do. And really the key things about our platform that differentiates us is we've actually built the platform from our expertise, not just in developing software, but also very clever algorithms, but combining that together with the neuroscience expertise that's widely recognized in the world. And those things together really put us in a strong position to provide very strong analytics to our customer base.
Before we talk more about the platform itself and the commercial strategy, where that's confirmed, where that's concerned, you took over as chief executive in February. Mm-hmm. Tell me a bit more about your own background.
Yeah, so I've been in the life science and diagnostics industries for just over 30 years. During that time, I've worked for very large companies, usually North American companies. So I've worked for the DuPont company for 14 years, where I built my commercial management career, if you like. After that, another key appointment was working for Thermo Fisher Scientific, which is one of the world's leading scientific equipment suppliers. And there I ran a $200 million business with about 1,500 employees. And that really gave me a lot of experience in terms of growing businesses internationally, not just in North America, but also some high growth territories like China and Brazil. And then more recently, I was with LGC, which is a UK-based life science and test and inspection business. And I ran the genomics business there. And in that business, the brief was to scale the genomics business significantly. And we were able to do that in a space of 3 years. We trebled the size of that business. It went from 150 employees to around about 500. So we're very proud of that. And we did that actually with a combination of growing the organic business through commercial expansion internationally, but also completing three major acquisitions in North America. So I was very, very proud of what we achieved there.
So what was the big appeal of IXICO? What did you spot about the company that you thought, yeah, too good an opportunity to miss?
Yeah, so the first thing was clearly a trusted partner to the pharmaceutical industry. And this has been built over 12 years. It's not something that's just a flash in the pan. And as I mentioned, because it's mission critical, it also tells me that these are strategic partnerships that our customers have and a relationship they have with IXICO. And in my first 100 or so days with the company, you know, what I've now learned is that actually of the 14 companies that operate in our focused area, which is neurological diseases, nine of those companies partner with IXICO. So we're a partner to those companies in supporting their programs. So that's very important. That was a very important point to me, is that there's clearly something about this company that is valued by their customers. The other thing is the opportunity to scale. Mm-hmm. And that's obviously the focus for myself and my management team now is to really scale this business, invest in the infrastructure, continue to invest in our digital platform, and really scale so that we can support our growth and our ambitious plans in the coming years.
You mentioned the focus there on neuroscience.
Yeah.
Are you limiting yourself in some way? I mean, how big is the brain market?
Right. So it's one of my first questions when I joined the company. And so if you take a step back, first of all, we obviously have an aging population, and that's driving a lot of concern around dementia, for example. Even, I think last week it was reported in the newspapers that by 2040, dementia in the UK in the UK is going to quadruple, and it's going to become the biggest killer in the UK. So there's a huge unmet medical need, and for that reason, lots of companies are investing in this space to develop new treatments. Clearly, it's not easy; otherwise, it would have been done by now. But what it says is, over the long term, we see significant opportunity for increasing our utility to those companies to try to address some of those questions. So if we look at what does neurological disease mean, it's Alzheimer's, it's Parkinson's, it's MS, mm-hmm. Huntington's, you know, these are all diseases that we've heard of. And as I said, all of them have large unmet medical needs that the pharmaceutical industry is investing hundreds of millions of dollars to try to address.
Give us a bit more detail then. How are you going to take advantage of these opportunities? What's the strategy?
So we have a six-point plan that's very clear internally that has enabled us to direct our efforts behind. And so the six-point plan is, first and foremost, it's all got to be geared around sustained top-line growth and a path to profitability. So as part of the company's evolution as a public company, that's the stage that we're now at. And so we are very focused on making sure that all of our efforts are driving that goal. Now what that means is an investment in the infrastructure and also in that digital platform so that we can scale and we can deliver consistent top line growth. The third point is we've talked about how we're a key partner to 9 of the 14 companies. The first thing in American speak we'd like to do is we'd like to get a bit more of our attainable market with those companies that are partnering with us today, our entitlement as the Americans call it. But also, what about the 5 that aren't using us? So we're very focused on more penetration into that customer segment that clearly values what we do. And we're going to do that by looking at how we get involved in further upstream in terms of the larger clinical trials and also other therapeutic areas they might be they might be using us in their work for Alzheimer's, but perhaps not for their MS area. So those are the sorts of things we're doing there. The fourth point of our plan is we are very, very pleased with the progress we're making in our commercial collaboration with a company called Biogen. Mm-hmm. This is an area where we've extended the reach of our integrated digital platform into clinical practice. And so our collaboration with Biogen is how to use our capabilities to enable them to support additional use of their Tysabri drug in the market, which is a leading treatment for MS. And that's going very well. And it's actually one of the reasons, in terms of our results for the first half, that's contributed versus prior year in terms of our revenue. So executing that and scaling up quickly to support that initiative is very important to our growth. Then the fifth point is, obviously there's a strong culture of innovation in the business, and so continued innovation with the appropriate level of support so that we do have a long-term growth strategy as well around new services over the next 3 to 5 years. And then finally, how do we accelerate that organic plan? It's with very targeted, complementary M&A. And so it's not a case of either or. We have to do them both in parallel, but it has to be on the back of a consistent year-over-year organic growth basis for the business. And then on top of that, we will add complementary M&A opportunities to accelerate our growth.
Very good. For those watching and who perhaps might be curious, wondering where's Derek? Derek, of course, the former chief executive. He's still with IXICO?
Absolutely, yeah. So Derek, one of the things I mentioned, we have a very strong culture of science and innovation. And obviously Derek was one of the founders of the company. That's very important for our long-term strategy. So hence, Derek is very much involved in that. But he's in particular, in our external relationships. So in actual fact, this week, he's actually flying to the US. He's a nominated speaker in the what's called the Alzheimer's Roundtable. And that's a very prestigious group of pharmaceutical companies that have actually invited IXICO, i.e. Derek, to present our expertise in a certain area. So it's quite impressive, I think, for a company of our size to have one of our executives invited to speak to that forum. So he's very much involved in external relations. And the other part as well is regulatory. Regulatory is very important to us. So our digital platform is all about gathering data that is regulatory compliant, because clearly pharmaceutical companies have to support their submissions with data that's regulatory compliant. And so what we're focused on, and Derek is very much supporting this initiative, is not just following the regulations, but actually being an influencer and an opinion leader of what those regulations should look like in new areas. And again, Derek is very well respected for his expertise there. So that's his role. So that's what you can expect from Derek in the coming weeks, months, and years.
Still playing a very active role.
Absolutely.
Look, before we get too carried away, one of the reasons we're here to talk, your interim's out this morning. Revenue for the 6 months to the end of March up 31% to £2 million.
Mm-hmm.
Are you pleased with those numbers?
Yeah, very pleased, very pleased. It's as a result of a combination of a lot of hard work, not just in the last 6 months, but prior to this six-month period. Obviously, we, as I said, are in strategic partnerships with multi-year clinical trials. So the first thing you have to do is make sure you win those contracts and those trials, and then you have to deliver them. And the results have really been, I think it's a reflection of the focus that we've placed on delivery. And the very pleasing thing from my perspective in terms of profitability as well is you'll see that focus has also resulted in reduced losses. And that's because we've been able to deliver with the same infrastructure. So it tells you that we have a scalable model. And so we're very pleased with not just the top line revenue, but the way we've delivered that revenue.
Very good. Well, I'll give you the brief final word to you. The outlook for the next 6 months, you're confident, you're excited?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, as I said, we've got some key strengths that we're building on. And those key strengths are really around the fact that we're a trusted partner, the fact that we have this digital platform that's unique and that's scalable. We have very strong plans in place to support our Biogen initiative. And we have great people. I mean, we should mention the fact that all of this is brought together by not just clever people, but very dedicated people. So I'd like to finish off by basically acknowledging and thanking our staff for all their efforts. And it's a beginning of a very exciting period for us. So I'm looking forward to working with everybody to make all those good things materialize into a very strong business that delivers sustainable growth and a very clear path to profitability.
I wish you all the best. Giulio, good to see you. Thanks very much indeed for coming in to see us.
Excellent. Thank you.